Welcome back. Whenever we chat with Samantha Jade, we're always left with a little bounce in our step. Yeah, you put that bounce in the step, in the step, in the step, in the step. Yeah, you put that bounce.
Well, like the rest of us, the pop powerhouse has been keeping a low profile during the pandemic. But lockdown is a lot easier when you have a brand new fur baby to play with. And for Sammy, her new four-legged friend is pure pup perfection. Aww. Samantha Jade joins us now live from her home in Sydney. Oh, you have to introduce us.
Hey. This is Banksy. Say hi.
Oh, Banksy's the cutest thing we've had on the show in a long time. Wow.
Oh, my gosh.
Gorgeous.
Yeah, he's so sweet. He really is.
How are you adapting to each other, Sam?
I mean, I'm obsessed with him. He is, I think he's obsessed with me too. He loves cuddles and he's just the sweetest. Because I have two dogs in Perth that are my family dogs, and I usually see them a lot. So I was like, I need to get a Sydney dog.
And why did you decide on this particular Sydney dog, apart from the fact that that's the most gorgeous face we've ever seen?
It's so cute. Look, we went and saw him, and you know how they say that you see the dog and you have a connection? Mm-hmm. It was like that.
Can we just talk about his eyebrows for just a moment? Like, oh, no. I know you do love a good brow, Samantha Jade, because you actually, I still use your brow gel stuff that you put out once.
Do you remember? Do you?
I do. I've still got that. It's great. Anyway, I digress. He's got the most adorable eyebrows.
He does have good brows. Yeah, that was the funniest thing when we saw him. And we were like, he has eyebrows. I've never seen a dog with eyebrows in my life.
He looks like Eugene Levy. You know, the dad from American Pie?
Totally, I do. And I love him. So that's great.
All right, you've got a heap of spare time on your hands now. Isolation's been the perfect time to think about, of course, some wedding plans. And we've got to ask you, because we are a tough-hitting news program, we ask the hard questions. How's the wedding progress?
I know you do always ask me. And I was actually excited for you because I actually started the process of planning.
Yes.
Had a few things actually planned and then had to put it all on hold because of COVID.
Okay, so what did you have planned, for instance? Where was it? When was it? Who was invited?
We only had one thing. We had a venue. But that's all I'll say.
Okay, and that's had to be put on hold. You can still be going through the magazines, looking at the good dresses and trying to get some ideas for napkins, decorations, that sort of idea.
Well, that's the thing. It's so much to plan, and I did start it, but now, now it's going to be perfectly planned, I guess, because I've got a lot more time.
Well, I want to say that's the most information you've ever given us ever, so thanks.
Yes, no worries.
Right. What about some new music?
New music? I'm so excited to say that I do have a song coming out in, I think, a few weeks, 3 or 4 possibly. We're just putting the final touches on it. I think right now music is so special, even more than ever. I think it's really connecting everybody. And I just wanted to make sure it was the right song with what everyone's going through right now, that it was saying the right thing.
Yeah, oh, good. We really look forward to that. Hey, your family.
Sorry, did you have to rewrite anything there for Sam or not?
Well, we actually had a song that we had planned to put out, and then we changed it last minute just so that it made sense for now. And you'll understand why when it comes out.
Oh, good. Okay.
Hey, your family's based over in Perth. You're really close as a family. You're struggling with that, or you're keeping in touch? What's going on?
Yeah, well, thank goodness for FaceTime and for House Party and all those apps, because we do that at least once a week. But it is really hard because I always get home at least once a month. So Mother's Day was tough not to be home with my family, and it was hard on my birthday too. But I'm hoping by Father's Day I can get home.
That would be nice. Yeah. We know that you have this long affiliation with the Salvation Army, and it is a special weekend this weekend with the Red Shield Appeal.
Yeah. So it's the Red Shield Appeal this year. It's the first time in, I think, 55 years that the Salvos haven't been able to do their traditional kind of door knocking on ground, which is what they're best known for. And obviously when you do look at that Red Shield, it does, I think, stimulate hope. It's what they stand for. So basically I usually go out on the road with them. We do some missions and we go help out people in need. But right now, you know, everyone's really in need, and not everybody, you know, can get to anyone right now. So basically what we can do is go to the website. You can also call 13 Salvos. And also if you go to Woolies to do your shopping, there is a donation button at the counter. So you can donate in all those different ways.
Yeah, absolutely. We've got to dig deep for them. You've witnessed how the money can support Aussies in need. So tell us how important these donations are right now.
Oh, so important. And I think, like you said, right now more than ever, it's so important. People are really struggling. People are going through really, really tough times. And all we can do is help. And seriously, the smallest donation helps in a big way. So don't be afraid to give big or small.
Yeah, so many charities doing it tough at the moment. It's a good message. Samantha Jade, lovely to see you. Lovely to meet Banksy.
Thanks, guys. Oh, yeah, say goodbye.
Yeah, time to take him for a walk, so we'll let you go. The Salvation Army's Red Shield Appeal is taking place digitally this weekend online. I will have all the details on our website.
How good was that exclusive? They booked a venue. But had to cancel it, but booked a venue. We finally cracked the nut, Kylie. We got there. Later this year, see you, Sammy. Later.